Hey everybody, we're going to rebuild a 6A-33 chuck by Jacobs. There are a lot of them out there, and we get a lot of questions about how to do this, so we're just going to show you all of it right now. Okay, unfortunately, we don't know where you can find the jaws or the nut for this chuck anymore. So if you have some of these old catalogs, we dug the codes out for you. So the code for the chuck is a 02067. It's a 0 to 1.5 inch capacity for a drill shank. The key is a K3. It's a taper mount, and the back, this part, is tapered, and it fits on what's called a tapered arbor, fits in your machine. And that taper there is a very specific one, and it's a 33 Jacobs taper. That's the name of the taper. And that's hence the name of the chuck, 6A-33. All right. If you can find some new old stock on eBay, a jaw or a nut, the kit is called a U6. Capital U6. And the sleeve is an S6, this outer sleeve. Now, there's a lot of arbors that interchange with a 33 Jacobs taper, and we know it goes from at least a Morse taper 0 to a Morse taper 4 on the other end. So 33 taper here, and then the other end of the arbor, 4 Morse taper to 0 Morse taper. Okay, 6A-33 over here in the press. These jaws are all flush with each other. I don't know if you can see that. They're all flush, same length, so this one feels like it's going to be rebuildable. There's lots of wood dust down here in these bevel gear teeth. And listen to this, I don't know if you get this. Dry as Sahara in there. So let's press it out. Now, for the 6As, unlike some of the other chucks, like the Super Chucks, you need to have the jaws about half open so that everything can clear when you're pressing the nut off. Sometimes if you put them all the way down in there, they'll hang up on the sleeve, cause you to cuss. Sometimes when they're all the way out, it's hard because they're out. So it's pretty stable about halfway out. Let's press it off. Nice service sleeve, makes it easy. Oh yeah. Now there's a little ridge in there that catches it, so the arbor doesn't fall out through your press. That central arbor right there. Yeah, so we'll take it the rest of the way apart on the bench over here. But basically, there's a big nut in here, and the jaws come in through these holes. There is a number here for each jaw. They're different and unique, 1, 2, and 3. If you're gonna rebuild it, and we are this one, you're gonna wanna keep the jaws together and it label them or something so you can put them back together. There's a trick around that if you forget or something, but keep track of them. Okay, this is exactly how it comes apart. This one's super sticky. Look at that big piece of leathery grease right there. Right there. It's not even hardly lubricating. Now, this nut is pretty special. It's one of the few things you're going to buy that's broken, and it's broken intentionally. It's called a cracked nut, broken nut, heard it called lots of things. But the only way to get it back on that arbor right there is if it comes apart, and they didn't want to have a fastener, so they broke it. There's some intentional little saw marks here where they weakened it so it would break where they wanted it to. Super clever design. Arthur Jacobs is the man. And once it's apart, you can take these jaws out. And that one's 2. Put it here. This one says 1. Towards you, number 1, and number 3 is towards me. And that's just sticky. So that's some pretty tight tolerance in there for where those jaws run. And look, just a little bit of corrosion, and look at all that wood dust right there. So this is where contaminants can get in to the chuck. And this is that wear spot. This is what starts making it sticky. But there's absolutely nothing wrong mechanically with these jaws. Yeah, look, all three of them are pretty ugly. There's one, two, and three. Hopefully that's kind of easy to see. So all I'm going to use is a little bit of Scotch-Brite, a little bit of elbow grease, and we're going to clean this thing up and put it back together with the little grease, and it's going to run perfectly. Yeah, this doesn't look too bad on the inside of this one. So we'll bring you back as soon as they're all cleaned up. Bang. This guy looks okay. Let's make him look great. Now these have a little bit of a few burrs right at the end. So the chuck jaw is okay. You could get pretty extreme and come in here and if you had a surface grinder, you could go to town on it, but let's get a few of these burrs off of here. And a little burr at the very end can really mess you up. Let me try to make sure I keep them in order. Just getting the big burrs off with a little hand file. Hopefully you can see that. It just, that might even be part of a bit that's stuck on the hardened jaw. Yeah, that just popped right off. So the jaw is fine underneath there. Now this is just a small stone, fine grit. I think there's 320 grit. And I'm just gonna come in here and hit either side just to make sure they're free. And then right in the middle, you gotta do this by feel, but it's flat across here. I'm just gonna give it a light rub. That's just gonna, not really take a lot of material off. That's really just getting that so it'll bite. So there's number one done. See how quick that was? One. You know, who knows what people have been drilling with these things. There they are. There's three jaws. See how this thing feels? Feels really good. Again, just trying to do this with stuff you probably have in your shop already. All cleaned up. Let's put it together. Let's get a little grease on it. If you're a detail guy, number two NLGI grease. If you're not a detail guy, doesn't matter. Whatever you got. The teeth need it. There's a little raceway right on top. Needs it. Now, on these crack nuts, split nuts, there's a chamfer on it on this edge right here, and it goes towards the front. There's really only one way for this stuff to go back together, and you can, if you're saving a buck, you might have to put it together twice. You may not make it all the way through the video. Ah, that feels really good. You want to make sure that turns good. One. Let's put a little grease on this guy. Now, if they don't pass this test right here, you know, you've got some more cleaning to do, or a burr or something somewhere. You want these things to slide in here and just slide real easy. Now it's hard for you to kind of know what I'm feeling here, but that really feels smooth. All right, let's put this on. Doesn't really matter where these go. But key thing is, let's push them all about halfway back out. And we want them flush. Maybe a little further, maybe about there, out there. That's pretty flush. Let's, now when it's all flush and they're all even, this should go on here real nice and easy too. And, one's sticking up too much, this one. So you gotta spread these a little bit, push it down a tooth, put the nut back on, get all three of them. You'll feel it when all three are together and they're all in the threads just right. That's it right there. Yep. That's a press fit, literally. So let's go press it back on. All right, now we're just back in a press and it really doesn't take much force at all, but especially when it's clean and lubricated. So, I mean, I'm just barely pushing on this. And when it's bottomed, you can tell, so you don't need to over-grunk it. And there's your new chuck. And that feels, I mean, that just glides on there just perfectly. So this might be what you see in your garage. Delta, Milwaukee, Rockwell maybe, Craftsman, Sears. But it's got a 6A. It looks like this one has some sort of surface finish that's dark on it. This one came in this shiny patina. But 6A, 6A, 33 taper, you can see it in there, that taper where this goes. If your chuck just falls out, it's just because it came loose in the taper. To put it back together, you don't want to lube this for sure. You want it to be dry, get some rubbing alcohol, clean it really good on both sides. A little tap with a hammer, it won't come out for another 50 years. Solid. So this one's all lubed up, feels good. We just got the wood dust out of it. And this one's still operating. This spins well, runs freely. Jaws look pretty good in this one. No need to fix that one. Still working.